This is the place.
Donnie, you're crowding me.
Sorry. Sorry. All that Splinter talk about how we're not ready has me thinking. Maybe we're in over our heads.
You're always in over your head.
I'm saying now we all are. And that scares me.
It's okay to be scared, Mikey. Raph is scared, too.
I am not scared.
You should be.
Brad, Brad, Brad!
Look what I found. Four soon-to-be ex-turtles.
I'm sure glad it's okay to be scared.
You and me both.
This is no time to panic.
Okay, maybe a little.
He keeps getting taller.
Then I'll cut him down to size. Let's stick together on this one.
This is hopeless.
Keep your head in the game.
I just want to keep my head on my body.
Come on, what are we retreating for? That's a good reason. Mikey, smoke!
What was that?
I'm stressed! Excuse me if my aim's a little off.
How hard is it to hit the ground?
Not so easy, is it?
Oh, well, you guys just...
Welcome back to the channel, ninjas. F-Dash here with F-TV. And we're back with more character spotlights for TMNT Legends. I'm joined once again by Asthma Queen Nicole. Nicole, everybody loved you and they wanted you back, so welcome back.
I appreciate everyone who requested I return.
Today we're talking about Dogpound. Nicole, get us started by looking at the tank Dogpound's level 80 stats.
Fun fact, Dogpound was Dash's first tank in this game. He had no idea who he was at the time. Some say he still doesn't. But he enjoyed using him. Isn't that right, Dash?
Yeah, no, that's actually true, yes.
This may surprise the viewers, but Dogpound has really low health. Lower than even Razar. His speed, accuracy, and dodge are also pretty bad, but he does have high attack power, defense, and crit rate. We've compared other tanks in the past to him and Nick Raff, so let's compare them to each other. They have the same speed, accuracy, dodge, and attack power, while Raff has more health and crit rate. We know that stats are only part of the puzzle, so let's shift our focus to his Tier 7 ability kit. Dogpound's basic, Mighty Punch, has a 50% chance to lower defense by 50% for a turn. Reverse attack up from your tank? Gotta love it.
Beware of Dog is a 3-turn taunt with a guaranteed chance to inflict attack down on enemies for 3 turns. The best part of this taunt is how slow Dogpound is, so he'll be actively taunting for a while. The attack down debuff is a nice cherry on top. Off the Leash is a single target attack that raises his attack power by 210%. This one's gonna hurt whoever it smashes, so use it accordingly. Dogpound's passive, Top Dog, has a 50% chance to raise his physical defense by 50% for 2 turns. This passive not only makes sense, but it makes him incredibly durable. You'll regularly see him taking 1 damage from enemies. It's great.
Shoulder Tackle is another single target attack that raises his attack power by by 230%. Off the leash is going to hurt, but shoulder tackle is going to murder. This one has a 5-turn cooldown, so use it wisely. Dog Pound isn't flashy and doesn't do anything terribly fancy. But what he does extremely well. From inflicting defense and attack, down to buffing his defense, and 2 devastating single-target attacks, Dog Pound was made to tank and dish out damage. And he's one of the best at doing them. We've long held Dog Pound in high regard, and deservedly so. He knows his role and plays it well. If you're wondering if farming Dog Pound is the right move, our question is why you haven't done it already.
Thank you for watching, ninjas. Keep it locked here for future TMNT videos. This was Turtle Legends. I've been F-for-F-TV, and we'll see you next time. Take it easy.